some sort of drama, something dramatic going on. I was not planning to do this video today, but yet again Chelsea forced me to, because there's just some crazy news that has come out. So yeah, apologies. Hopefully, if Chelsea can just stay, that's all I'm asking for, just stay under the radar for the rest of the season, please, so that I can release normal videos. I don't have to be doing this all the time, because I really don't want to do this. But today we're talking about the potential return, or maybe the return, of Frank Lampard to Chelsea. So as of recording, it's looking like 90% sure that Frank Lampard will become caretaker manager of Chelsea till the end of the season. It's not confirmed yet, so maybe it's broken down, but I'm pretty sure by the time you watch this, it will be confirmed. So, yeah, I don't think anybody expected this, but first and foremost, this is a clear PR move. The owners have thought, right, we need to get the fans back on our side, let's hire a club legend, hopefully he can create a sort of feel-good factor, distract the fans and buy us some time to get the next appointment right. Do I blame them for doing that? No, not necessarily. But is this actually a good PR move? I don't. I'm unconvinced, and we'll get into it. But first I wanted to talk about simply the idea of getting a caretaker manager now, and why I personally don't think that is the right decision, regardless of if it's Lampard. Now, usually, I would say in this situation, caretaker, fine, you know, just get us to the end of the season, end the season. But in this specific scenario, it looks like Luis Enrique and Nagelsmann are the two main candidates for the job. And they are both available and ready now. That's quite unique that your two, you know, most favourite candidates are actually available and unemployed. So, when you're in a situation like this, it's a case of, why are you going to wait to the end of the season? You want to get them in now, get them used to the players, so they can understand who they like, who they don't like, start building and implementing their system with the players, and hopefully start to build the project now. Now, I understand maybe they don't want to bring them into some sort of like negative environment or something like that, get a fresh clean slate, fresh season. But I think it's better for me someone comes in now and starts clearing out the players, putting ideas in place, and this season still needs salvaging. We need to get top six. Like, I want to be at least in the Europa League next season, and we can still do that. So you bring in Enrique, if that's the man they want to get, that's fine, but bring him in now. Why are you going to wait? He's available, he's ready, he's there. Bring him in now and let's get on with it, rather than get a caretaker in. I would understand if the person you wanted maybe was in a job, let's say it's Spalletti at Napoli, you know, he wants to see out the season, fine, get him in the summer, but it looks like it's Nagelsmann or Enrique, and both are available right now, so what exactly are you waiting for? But let's talk about Lampard then. The return of Frank Lampard as Chelsea manager. Let's start with the good. So, I guess it's going to be vibes, right? It'll be vibes. The Chelsea fans will be behind him. It should theoretically ease the negativity around the club. Everyone will be feeling good. Lamps is back, yay, club manager. Nice and good, positive vibes, right? You know, new manager bounce and all that. He's also very good with youngsters as well, and he gives them chances, develops them pretty well. Tammy Abraham, Reece James, Mason Mount, Tomori, these guys were all given debuts in Lampard's first season at Chelsea, and they developed pretty nicely under him. So hopefully we have a young squad now. Hopefully he will work well and develop people shield. All these guys are quite young. He should hopefully work well with them. Because I guess if you go get like a gas hitting or something like that, he's not really, some guy's going to work well with youngsters, but Lampard hopefully should. But as for the bad, well, this is where my main problem comes in. So firstly, what about the players he fell out with? If you cast your mind back to when Lampard was sacked, there were reports that he lost the dressing room, and particularly some of the senior members of the squad he fell out with, and some of them are still there. For example, Kepa is our number one, and he's had one of his better seasons in a Chelsea shirt this year. But under Lampard, this guy was number two. Mendy came in to replace him. He had one of his worst ever seasons. So what's going to happen with him? Kovacic, another one of those players Lampard clearly fell out with, because he fell out with, he didn't really use him towards the back end. Kai Havertz wasn't particularly great under Lampard either. So do all these guys get dropped, or do they start causing problems? What's going to happen with them? There's like already baggage attached with Lampard, if you get what I mean. Then there's players like Mount, who he loved. Hakim Ziyech, Christian Pulisic, he was big fans of these guys. Conor Gallagher, he tried to sign at Everton. So all of these players I just named, they're all on the fringes right now. So do they come back in the side? And if they do, that just blocks the development of other players who are meant to be here for the future. All of those guys I just mentioned most likely will not be here next season. So what's happening there? And another problem is, for example, let's say Lampard brings Ziyech and Pulisic into the team and drops Mudryk and Sterling from the team, right? And let's say we get Luis Enrique in the summer. What if Enrique comes in and he says, actually, I don't like Mudryk, and no, I like Mudryk and Sterling, I don't like Ziyech and Pulisic, I want to sell those two. Then basically you've just wasted all this time, that half of the season, playing Ziyech and Pulisic, when the new manager doesn't even want them. And that could have been spent on getting minutes under the belt of someone like Mudryk. You see, there's just such conflict with this, having him as caretaker manager. And also, on top of that, he's just not a very good manager, is he? Like, I love Lamps. He was a fantastic player. The first season at Chelsea, he did pretty well under the circumstances, to be fair. It was pretty nice. But I can't ignore what happened in that second season. I can't ignore what he did at Everton. He's literally come off the back of, essentially, if he was still in charge of Everton, they would be going down. Like, they were rubbish. And he's somehow gone from that walking into the Chelsea job. Like, make it make sense. I don't know. And you know what's scaring me as well is we've got Real Madrid in the Champions League. So you're really telling me Frank Lampard is going to come up against Carlo Ancelotti's Real Madrid Champions League winning side at the Bernabeu over two legs and outclass him? Like, really? Even if he has a new manager bounce, he isn't doing anything. It could be scary. You know, Liverpool lost 6-2. Jurgen Klopp lost 6-2 on aggregate to Carlo Ancelotti's Madrid side. Imagine what this Madrid side will do to Lampard's team. Like, it's awful. It's awful. Look, I don't want to come across as hating on Lampard. Obviously, if he comes in, I'll back him. You know, it'll be nice to see Lampard back at the bridge, back in a Chelsea manager yet again. And it'll also be good for him, you know, a little short-term thing just to get himself back on track as a manager and revive his career a little bit, get himself back in the public eye, because if he does well, then, you know, he will be able to get some other jobs, maybe in the Prem after this. such a bad fashion, they didn't necessarily achieve too much, and some of the players don't necessarily get along with the guy. He already has a relationship with a lot of them there. He has his favourites. His style of play is kind of different, I guess, to Enrique or Marksman, whoever comes in. So it's like, I just don't see this point here in getting Lampard as caretaker. I really don't see it. I don't know, maybe I'm being a bit harsh on Lampard. Let me know, what do you think, Chelsea fans? You happy he's back? Rival fans as well? Neutrals, let me know, because yeah, you can clown us in the comments, you can clown Chelsea in the comments, that's fair enough. I saw someone like but comment recently was like, be careful what you wish for, because it might get worse. And to be fair, this could get worse if Lampard performs the way he did at Everton here. Oh god, we might generally be in a relegation scrap, because we're only like 6 points ahead of Crystal Palace, so that, as long as we don't get relegated, I'll take that. But yeah, that's my thoughts on Lampard coming back. Personally, don't really want it. Probably gonna happen, probably has happened by the time you're watching this, but I'm hoping it's fallen through and you're not actually gonna see this video, because I won't release it if he's not coming. So yeah, if you haven't watched this,